I can't smell asparagus. What's up guys, in this episode I go through 23andMe and how reliable the results might be for a South Asian or Indian or Pakistani or Bangladeshi or Sri Lankan. So keep watching if you want to find out. Time to get our hands dirty. On a side note, don't you think it's really odd that after Google searching 23andMe, Facebook now thinks I might be interested in buying it? Anyway, how reliable are your results from 23andMe? Should you trust absolutely everything that 23andMe says? Or should you take it with a grain of salt? Or should it be something in between? We're gonna find out. I thought of making this video after I watched this one, and I realized that a lot of genetically identical twins are getting separate results. So 23andMe thinks that their genetic heritage are different. Is this even possible? No. It's quite easy to be misinformed about what 23andMe actually does to your DNA samples. So most people have 23 times 2 or 46 chromosomes. In those chromosomes, there are about 3 billion base pairs. 23andMe is not sequencing all 3 billion of those base pairs. That would be way too expensive for a service that's around $100 or £100. 23andMe looks at what are called SNPs, SNPs. SNPs are essentially tiny variations in your genome that can express certain outcomes. There are certain SNPs or variations in genomes that can result in certain types of diseases. There are certain SNPs that only people of certain geographical locations might have. They might have not been born in that area, but the people that were originally located in that region would have had those SNPs. Detecting those SNPs in your genome, 23andMe can tell whether you're Polish or German or Indian or West Indian. 23andMe is essentially making conclusions from the tiny variations in your genome. And it looks at those genotypes and thinks that those genes are gonna express certain types of proteins that result in this type of expression. And this type of expression in terms of proteins will result in a person with a certain characteristic. It's very important that I mention here that a lot of factors actually contribute towards the way a person might be or the way you are, the things you like, and the diseases that you might contract in your lifetime. It's not just genotype, which means that if you smoke, it's very likely that at some point in your life, you may end up getting lung cancer. Genes are not everything. Environment also plays a very, very strong role in getting diseases like cancers. So let's have a look at my ancestry report. Okay, that was a complete waste of money. If your second name is Patel, let me do you a favor and tell you where you're from. It's really important to remember that the results you're getting from your 23andMe analysis only represents what is a probability of you getting a certain outcome. If your 23andMe results are saying that you have a high likelihood of late onset Alzheimer's disease, it doesn't mean that you're necessarily gonna get Alzheimer's disease. It just means that probabilistic algorithms are pointing towards a higher risk of late onset Alzheimer's in you. I love how an article in the Scientific American has put this. They say that genetics is a probabilistic science and there is no gene that codes for anything in particular. It's genes together plus environment that lead to consequences. Even having genes like those for blue eyes does not necessarily always correspond to having blue eyes. It's still a probability. So although it was quite a lot of fun to find out that I'm 100% Indian, which I always knew, I would say there was actually no use at all from it. It may be exciting to read genetic analysis reports for the first time, but at the end of the day, 23andMe is relying on entertaining you rather than actually giving you something for certain or for sure. My verdict is that do not take 23andMe or other genetic tests seriously at this point in time. There are definitely gonna be ways to get genetic analyses done for cheaper prices and with higher accuracy in the future. The price of a report right now is about $200. Granted, 23andMe is an excellent service for many people and is pioneering a whole new area of research. But on the other hand, it got quite a few things wrong. I don't hate cilantro or coriander as it predicted. I actually love coriander. I'm Indian, come on. And I don't personally believe my caffeine consumption is lower than average. If there's anything else that you would like me to review, then let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a nice day.